Madame César, on y a dit à mon camarade PS. I love you. And God is going to bless your life in the name of Jesus. As Pastor Rebecca said, let me take this opportunity to tell you that you can have your pen. And you can have your Bible near you so that you read it as I read. In the name of Jesus. May the Lord bless you as you open your Bible. Because the relationship with God is good, God enabled them to carry this ministry. Hallelujah. So the relationship with God is so important, my brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. The Bible said in the book of Amos, chapter 3, verse 2, the Bible said that of all nations on the earth, you are the only one I have chosen. Wow, such a wonderful and powerful message. I'm the chosen one. Hallelujah. You are the chosen one. Let me do something, my brothers and sisters. You are not alone. You are not alone. There is someone who chose you. There is someone who chose you. When you were dumped somewhere, someone came and chose you. I'm the chosen one. Hallelujah. You are the chosen one. Praise God. When I realized that, even if there are challenges, I walk like a chosen one. And every time you find a smile on my face, it's not that I don't meet challenges, but because there is someone who chose me. Hallelujah. He chose me. He chose me from far. And he is God. When the Bible says that I'm the chosen one, that is enough. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are the chosen one. I chose you. You are the only one I have chosen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But as you continue, that's why I will punish you. Because of your sins.
Hallelujah.
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 I'm the chosen, but because of some problems with me, God punishes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me give you this testimony. One time, I was coming from school
when
I was young, and I was doing bad things with my friend, and my father was coming back home. And when he reached where we were, he said, "What are you doing, guys?" He said, "I'm sorry. You know what my father did? My father came and get a stick in African way. You know, in African way, our parents used to cane us. And he caned me 5 sticks. And I did my father to cane my friend as well. And he didn't. When you reached home, I asked my father, what happened? We were two, but you caned me. But my friend, you didn't. My father said, I caned you because I love you. Your friend, I don't know him. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Amen.
And I was, my father caned me because he loves me. Hallelujah. And when we reached home, I was like, I need to know why I was punished. And my friend, they just let him go. Praise God. But my father, father told me that I was caned because of love between me and my father. I went back to what I was doing. And I realized that what I was doing was bad. Because what I was doing was bad. Then that's why my father caned me. And from that day, I didn't go back there. Praise God. The Bible says, in the book of
Amos,
that that's why I will punish you because of your sins. Hallelujah. I think that is better than someone looking at you doing something bad and doesn't say anything to you. Hallelujah. That's why I love my brother Maxon and my sister Becky. Because when do something wrong, they come to you, but you know that what you are doing is wrong. And that is love. Hallelujah. Praise God. So my brothers and sisters, it's good to keep your relationship with God. Because your relationship with God is so important. Praise God. Your relationship with God, it is so important. And let me tell you something. I'm the first beneficiary if my relationship with God is good. Hallelujah. So brothers and sisters, as you are there watching, it's good to check on your relationship. Our Father is with our Savior. Because the Bible says that because of our sins, it punishes. It doesn't kill us. It punishes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that's why the Holy Spirit told me to teach you about this. Because being punished, it doesn't mean that he doesn't love us. Praise living God.
Amen. Just because our God loves us, whenever we do wrong, he punishes
us.
It's so important to keep our relationship. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God loves us. Yes, Ogalwachi.
That's why he punishes us for the
wrong. All we need to do is to come back to him and repent. And we say, Father, we sin. We need for your forgiveness. We still need your love. The Bible is in the book of Hosea, chapter 7. Hosea, chapter 7, verse 10. Hosea chapter 7 verse 10. My Bible says, I'm the Lord, their God. I'm the Lord, their God. But in all of their troubles, their pride keeps them away from returning to me. Because of their troubles, keeps them away from me. Let me tell you something. When you face some troubles, when you face some challenges,
let
not chase you away from God. In God's presence, when you face some challenges, when you face some troubles, it's time to come back to our Father. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And say, Lord, we are here for you. We still love you. Maybe we did something wrong. But Father, you can forgive us. You can please forgive us. We are still children because you chose us from very far. Hallelujah. We are the chosen ones. Brothers and sisters, even if you did something wrong, you are still the chosen one. It's good to come up to the Father. Remember what I told you, that after being came, I went back to my Father. I
and he said, why did you came me? And you didn't my friend. Then my brother told me, I came to you. You are my son, and I love you. I don't want you to be like the other one. Hallelujah. Praise God. So,
friends,
our God loves us.
He loves us. Even this situation, even this situation of coronavirus and many a lot of things happening.
He
still loves us. He's going to protect you. He's going to protect your family. He needs you to come back to him and cry unto him. Hallelujah.
Pray
for your family.
Pray
for your nation. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God. Why I love Uganda. We pray
to Saba.
When times pray, we pray
to Savida.
We can pray from 7 p.m. to 6 a.m.
to someone who saw what we saw in my regular papa's
hallelujah. Bishop Maxwell is always inviting us at this church.
Bishop Maxwell, we can say that one is our
he keeps us there. From evening to morning, no one getting tired. And let me tell you something, he's there as well. He hasn't gone away. Hallelujah. We pray as he prayed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We need to pray for each other. We need to pray for our families. Praise God. We need to repent. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We need to come back to him. Because he chose us. He chose us. Let's open up
the Bible.
In the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter
1,
verse
7.
2 Chronicles, open your Bible.
In
the book of 2 Chronicles. Hallelujah. 2 Chronicles, I'm opening mine. 2 Chronicles from verse 1. No, from chapter 1. Verse 7. The Bible says, God appeared to Solomon at night in the dream and said, Solomon, ask for anything you want and I will give it to you. Verse 8 said, Solomon said, Solomon answered, Lord God, you always royal to meet my father David. And now you have made me a king of Israel.
That's
what he said. I am supposed to rule those people. But there are many of them. And they are speaking of the dust on the ground. So keep the promise you made to my father. Verse 10 says, and make me wise. Give me the knowledge. I need to be the king of this great nation of yours. David had cried to God because of his son Solomon, that my son is young. How is he going to become
a
king? Praise Jesus. And when Solomon became a king, he came to God. And God told him, ask whatever you need, I'll give it to you. You know, it's what we call touching God's heart. Touching God's heart. Let me tell you something, my brothers and sisters. Touching God's heart. It's a big thing. But some of it, the first thing I know, God's heart is about his people. Hallelujah. God's heart is about his people. Praise God. If you want to keep your relationship with God, you must love his people. Praise Jesus. You must love his people. And you know Solomon touched God's heart. And you know the Lord said, in verse 11, Solomon, you could have asking me to make you rich and famous, or to let you live a long time, but you ask me for your enemies to be destroyed. Instead, you asked me for wisdom and knowledge to rule my people. Verse 12, I will make you wise, intelligent, but you also make you rich and also, let me read it once again, but I will also make you richer and more famous than any king before or after you. Hallelujah. King Solomon touched God's heart because of his people. Hallelujah. When the Lord asked Solomon to ask whatever he wants, Solomon said, I need wisdom. And that wisdom is not going to get me, because and I have to rule your people. Because you gave me a chance to rule your people, I need your people to be happy. I need your people to be in the better life. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Solomon touched God's heart. Let me tell you something. You might be that there are things that you cannot buy in the shops. Hallelujah. There are things you cannot buy in the shops or in the stores. There are things you cannot buy. You cannot buy favor. Hallelujah. You cannot buy, like, let me go in the store so that I can go order and order. Hallelujah. Because someone may say, let me go in the store and I buy yes. You cannot. But let me tell you something. God has it. If you want it, you love his people. When you love his people, he will give you things you cannot buy. Brothers and sisters, there are things you cannot buy in the stores. But God has them. Solomon didn't ask for riches.
No.
Solomon didn't ask for anything. He asked for wisdom so that he can rule. Praise Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let me tell you something. People who are watching and you people who are here, I love Pastor Maxon because he loves people. Hallelujah. He loves people. And he loves God's people. Praise God. He loves people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God bless him because he loves people. Hallelujah. When I reached here, someone told me, when that someone that people comes on pastor's home, I
want to
we need something to eat. We need something to drink. We
are
hungry. Hallelujah. Because they know that when they go there, there is a solution. Let me tell someone who is watching. What did you do when people comes to you? You hide. Maybe you hide your food. Maybe you hide your money. Maybe you close your door. You don't like them. But let me tell you something. Those are God's chosen. Hallelujah. If you love them, he will love you. If you care about them, he will care about you. Hallelujah. There is a devil going to Lugazia. Pastor Maxon is orphanage.
I
saw children over there. He educated them. He is not rich, but he shares his heart with them. Hallelujah. God's love is about God's people.
When you
love his people,
he will
give you things you cannot buy in shops.
When you
take care about his people,
he will
take about you.
Let
me tell you something. He doesn't do that because he has a lot. No. Because of God's heart. And that's where he touches God's heart. He's good. If you want to touch God's heart, love his people. That's what Solomon did. He didn't ask for riches. He didn't ask for chariots. He didn't ask for anything. He didn't ask for power to kill his enemies. He said to God, I need wisdom.
Hallelujah.
I need wisdom. When can you get wisdom? Out of seeking the Lord. When you seek the Lord, he will give you wisdom. The word seek means seeking God's knowledge. When you have this knowledge, you can do things as God does them.
It's
good.
Hallelujah.
Amen. When you have that, you have God's knowledge, you can do incredible things.
It's
good.
As a
closing, let's read the book of John chapter
21.
John
chapter
21.
In
the book of John chapter
21.
Hallelujah. Praise God.
Amen.
John chapter 21 from verse 15. The Bible says that when Jesus and his disciples had finished eating, he asked Simon, son of John, do you love me more than the other do? Hallelujah.
Amina.
Simon Peter answered,
Simon Namudam,
yes, Lord.
We
you know, I do. Then Jesus answered, feed my lambs.
This sanga.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Verse 16.
Jesus
asked the second time,
Simon,
son of John,
wana wa Yokana,
do you love me?
Unjagala.
Peter answered, yes, Lord.
Na
you know that I love you.
Jesus
said, take care of my sheep.
Lunda and the Gaza.
Jesus told him,
yes,
verse 17. Jesus asked him the third time, Simon, son of John,
mwana wa Yokana,
do you love me?
Unjagala.
Hallelujah.
Amina.
Why Jesus asked Simon three times?
What Yesu abuza Petra minundi esatu?
The same question.
Chibuzo chechimu.
And he's giving him the same answer.
Atina ya mwanga answer echoko damu chechimu.
Hallelujah.
Amina.
If Simon loves me,
Simon waba njagala.
Feed my sheep.
Decent Gaza.
Feel my sheep.
Decent Gaza.
Hallelujah.
Amina.
If you love me, feel my sheep.
Decent Gaza.
I told you,
Kugami,
that why I love Pastor Maxson. Even churches are closed.
Amakanisa
he's trying his level best to feed the sheep.
Let's
look for him, brothers and sisters.
Hallelujah.
The churches, even though the churches are closed, God is trying his level best so that the sheep is fed. And now, you are online watching because he's trying his level best so that the gospel can reach your house. Hallelujah. The gospel can reach your bedroom. Praise God.
Amen.
The gospel can reach everywhere you are.
Actually,
this is incredible. Many countries are watching. Uganda is watching.
Uganda.
Other countries overseas are watching.
when the gospel can reach you, not because it's very rich, he buys data so that he can feed the sheep. And when you feed the sheep, you touch God's heart. Praise God. When you feed his sheep, touch his heart.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you feed his sheep, you touch his heart. You touch his heart. Praise God. So brothers and sisters, who are watching, I request you, support this ministry. Support it.
Hallelujah.
Support which is supporting you.
Hallelujah.
Support this ministry. In the name of Jesus. When you support this ministry, you touch people's, you reach people, God's people. Reach all these people. And when you reach all these people, you touch God's heart. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As you are there, I'm going to pray for you so that you continue reach God's people. And God touches you, and then you touch God's heart. God is going to bless you. God is going to bless your family. He's going to protect you. He's going to keep you. He's going to provide for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for this opportunity to bring me here at Revival Palace. Father, I thank you because you enabled me to speak to your people and feed your sheep. Father, as they are listening to this gospel, as they are praying with me, as I'm praying to them, Father, may you keep them, may you touch their hearts, may you protect them, Father, may you guide them, may you protect their families, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the name of Jesus, support those ones who are supporting your work, love them in the name of Jesus. Especially those ones who love you people. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I pray for Pastor Maxon, Pastor Rebecca, and their ministry. Father, may you bless them. As they reach by your people, may you protect them. May you keep them well. May you provide whatever they need in life with their children. In the name of Jesus. And their grandchildren. Kids, they will never suffer. They will never lack something to eat. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, bless everyone who loves your people. In the name of Jesus, who blesses your people. In the name of Jesus, Father, thank you for this day. Thank you, Father, for this afternoon. May you bless everyone who are here and those ones who are watching. In the name of Jesus. Amen. May the Lord bless you. Thank you so much for watching us. May the Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. Let me invite Pastor Rebecca to take us ahead in the name of Jesus. May God bless you, Pastor Rebecca.
We are going to be having visitors from Kenya, from South Africa, from Australia, from Australia.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God bless you. Have a nice day.